I live in LA now. It's weird. I feel like this is the longest time I've been in the city and I haven't asked for weed. I'm glad my kids will be watching this. I felt proud of that. And it's weird how like weed is affecting my life now because I don't like, you know, I live in a city where it's legal now and I don't know if I like it. I don't like buying my weed from a store. I like buying my weed from a drug dealer. That's what I'm good at. I've been practicing for years and now it's an obsolete skill. Thank you. I don't want to get it from a store. I'm sorry. And I know it's better, but it's like, I don't like the government having a hand in everything. It's kind of like when you're like 13, your parents are like, you could have a party, but we got to be upstairs. You know what I'm saying? I don't like it. Cause like I find myself lying at my dispensary the same way I do when I go to like a really nice bar and they give me like some really good liquor and I don't know what I'm tasting. The bartender's like, oh, taste this. This is a 28-year-old scotch. Do you taste that? That's oak on the back of your tongue. I'm like, I don't know what oak tastes like. I've lived a great life. But I still gotta be like, I taste that. I feel it's salty. I don't know what I'm drinking. And it's the same way when I go to my dispensary, I want to get my weed and leave, but I can't because I got to get a fucking TED talk from a weed dispensary person. As soon as I walk in, I just want to leave. I don't want to be here. And as soon as I walk in, they're like, Al, good to see ya. We've got some shit in this week. I'm like, fuck. All right, now, these are sativas. Now, me and my boyfriend, we'll do this if we're going to do like a Game of Thrones marathon. He's more into this than I am. I don't care for it, but he likes it. What I go for is more than indica. It's more of a full body high. And I'm like, I don't even know what a full body high is. And they're like, it's awesome. They're like, your head's completely clear, but your body is high. And I'm like, when the fuck would I ever need that? What, am I performing surgery on myself tonight? Here's what I need to know about my weed. My wife and kids are gonna be home from the mall in 45 minutes. Is that gonna be enough time for me to pull my shit together so I don't scar my child with some high-ass dad shit when he comes? Well, I'd be like, stop at the door, your daddy's been thinking. The government is trying to kill the black man via the dollar menu. It's written on White Castle's website, but it's written backwards. Open your third eye. I think your mom's a cop. Okay.
This is awesome, man. This is great.
And I'll tell you, I'll be real with y'all. We got a long time up here. We need to just start to get to know each other. I celebrate diversity. I think you just hang out with people of different races, different ages. I think that's all good. But I'll be honest with y'all, I practice segregation one time in my life and one time only. And that's that I only smoke weed with people in my own age demo. Shut up, I do. I'm in my mid-30s, I smoke with people in our mid-30s, we smoke old people shit. Joints, blunts, maybe a bowl if somebody got a promotion, we getting fancy, you know? I want to smoke with young people, but they got a lot of equipment. They got a lot of shit you gotta know. They're like, I was like, hold the button down. I'm like, I don't know what's happening, I don't wanna do this. Because they always trick you. It's like, you know, an 18-year-old kid be like, hey, Al, you want to smoke? And I'm like, man, I got a little time. All right, let's do it. And they're like, do you know that thing that they usually do T-shirts into the stands at NBA games? I'm like, I've seen that. We put weed in that now. Get on your knees. I'm like, I have kids. Not...